Hello all. In this particular tutorial, I'll be talking about a feature called Oracle Flex ASM, which was introduced in Oracle 12c. However, this particular video is recorded on Oracle 19c, hence the title Oracle 19c. I have prepared this diagram to explain you how the Oracle Flex ASM works. Is in the previous releases, if your the ASM instance had to be running on every node. So if that particular ASM instance goes down, then the, all the instances running on that particular node will go down. However, Oracle has introduced a concept of Flex ASM, in which if ASM instance for any reason on a particular node goes down, then the instances on that particular node will switch their connection to the another ASM instances which are there in that particular cluster. We can also set up our cluster in such a way that there is a DB instance which is running on node 2 and ASM instance which is running on node 3. So it is not mandatory for us to have ASM instance running on the same node as the DB instance. How to check if the Flex ASM is enabled? We have two commands. We can use ASM CMD show cluster mode, or we can use CRSCTL get cluster mode status. The testing that we are going to do is we are going to first verify that our ASM is running on both the instances. Then we are going to verify using the gv$asm client. We are going to verify our connections to the ASM instance. We can use gv$asm client view, or we can use ASM CMD LSCT. So we can use any of this. Then we are going to stop the ASM on one of the nodes, and then we are going to verify that our database is still up and running and it is now connected to the other surviving ASM instance. So it's going to be a pretty simple tutorial. So let me connect to the PuTTY session on for the both the nodes. So this is DB1, the node 1, and this is the DB2, which is node 2. So I've connected to two nodes. So that's done. Now what I'll do is I will run this particular command to show you what is our cluster mode. So we can use ASM CMD show cluster mode. So for that, I need to set up the ASM environment. So let me go as a root, or as a grid user, you can use any of this. So let me set the environment variable to ASM1 for node 1 and run this command ASM CMD show cluster mode. And you should be able to see that our cluster is flex mode enabled. I can also run another command called CRSCTL get cluster mode status. So let me run that command as well. And you can see cluster is running in flex mode. So we are good. Our cluster is flex enabled. So now what I'll also show you that the ASM instance is running on both the nodes. So let me do that. So you can see plus ASM running on node 1 and the ASM instance is running on node 2. We can also use this particular command SRVCTL status ASM detail to check whether the ASM instance is running on both the nodes. So let's do that. So let me run this particular command. And you can see, you should be able to see that we have ASM2 running on node 2 and ASM1 running on node 1. In this particular output, you should also see, so let me clear the screen and run this particular command once again. And you should be able to see that there are two clients connected to node 1 and two clients connected to node 2. Sorry, node 2, two clients, this is node 2, and node 1, two clients. And the both the ASM instances are up and running. So now what I'll do, we can verify the same thing using the SQL developer. So let me do here. I'll run this particular query, and you can see that instance 2 is connected to ASM2. Instance 1 is connected to ASM1. We can also use this particular command to get the same output. So we can use this particular command to get the same output, and you can see that we have ASM1, the instance 1 connected to ASM1. So we can see that, and we can run the same command on the second node as well. So now what remember this particular point, okay, number of clients connected to, okay, remember this particular point. So now what I'll do, I'll go here and I will stop my ASM instance. So SRV, so let's go as a root, set the environmental variable and SRV CTL stop ASM on minus node 2, which is DB2. In my case, the second node is node 2. So I'm stopping this. So once that is done, okay, let's wait for it to come back, and then we'll verify that our ASM has gone down. So using ps-ef, we'll verify that our ASM instance has gone down. So let's give it a minute. Once the ASM instance is gone down, then we should be able to see. So let's see whether actually the connection is switched over. And as you can see, both the instances are now connected to the ASM1 because ASM2 has been stopped. Okay. And if I run this particular command, okay, you can see we do not have the PMON process for ASM2. But let's see what happens, what happened with our database. So let's go as our database and set that and SQL plus as sysdba. So let me connect to the database. Select name, comma, open mode from v$database. And you can see that our database is now in the read-write mode. However, the ASM is not running on that particular instance. If I run this particular command once again, you should be able to see that the C12, the second instance, is also now connected to here. Okay, so let's give it a minute. You can see the C12 is also, so previously only one instance, but now that second instance has also connected. We can verify using gv$asm that both the instances are now connected to ASM1. And you can see, I'll run this particular command, and this particular command, now ASM2 is running on node 2. This should not be there because we have stopped it. So let's give it a minute. And you can see that ASM is only running on DB1. It is not running on DB2. And now the clients have gone from 2 to 3 because now the second instance has also came to DB1. If I start the ASM again, so let me go back as root, start my ASM. So, I stopped it. So let's go from here, SSH DB2. So I'm going to node 2. And set the environmental variable, which is plus ASM2. And I'm going to say srvctl start ASM minus node DB2. So I'm going to start it on node 2. Once the ASM is started, then automatically this connection, this instance C12, is going back to ASM1. So let's verify it. So you can see instance 1 is also connected to 1. Instance 2 is connected to ASM1. So let's see that it switches back to ASM2, and you can see ASM instance 2. So if whatever happened internally, we did not move those instances to the surviving ASM. That was done by the Oracle transparently. We do not have to intervene in that particular feature. So, and even if the ASM instance on a particular node goes down, then your database will still be up and running, and it will switch to surviving ASM instance. This is the concept of Flex ASM. This is the concept of Flex ASM, and you can have your database running without the ASM instance running. I hope this particular tutorial was useful. In this particular tutorial, we saw how the Flex ASM works, and if you are facing an Oracle interview question, probably an interviewer is going to ask you this particular question. So just see this particular video to understand. If you liked my video, do subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and see you in next tutorial. Bye-bye.